One of these men flew a fully loaded communist airliner through the Iron Curtain to freedom. What is your name, please?
My name is Mira Slovak.
My name is Mira Slovak.
My name is Mira Slovak.
Two of these people are imposters. Only one is the real Mira Slovak and is the only one sworn to tell the truth. Now, here's our host, Bud Collier.
Thank you very much. Welcome once again to The Tell the Truth, brought to you this week by Helene Curtis, makers of fine beauty products, creators of Enden Dandruff Treatment Shampoo and Tender Touch Dry Skin Bath Oil. Now may I introduce our panel. First, Mr. Tom Poston. Second, and we're mighty glad to have her back, Miss Kitty Carlisle. Then Mr. Don Amici. And finally, Miss Polly Bergen. Got your affidavit envelopes. Will you please open them and take out your first affidavit card and follow along as I read. I, Miro Slovak, made international headlines 7 years ago when I landed a fully loaded Czechoslovakian passenger airliner at an American base in Germany and walked away to freedom. I am now a co-pilot for Continental Airlines. As a hobby, I drive racing hydroplanes, fast, high-powered motorboats which travel at speeds around 170 miles per hour. Last year, I won the President's Cup race on the Potomac River. Next month, I will drive in the famous Gold Cup race. And the day after the race, I will receive my United States citizenship. Signed, Miro Slovak. Three stalwart gentlemen for this first round of challenges panel, all claiming to be Miro Slovak, who flew an airliner to freedom outside the Iron Curtain. We'll start this questioning with Polly Bergen. Polly?
Thank you, Bud. Mr. Slovak, number one, who won, what is the name of the boat that won the President's Cup race the year before you won it? It would be 1958.
Wahoo.
Wahoo, number two, do you agree with that? Number two?
I don't recall.
Number three, who owned the winning boat in 1958?
Pepsi.
Number one, who is the president of Continental Airlines?
Mr. Six.
Number two, what exactly caused the incident of your flying the Czechoslovakian passenger airliner out of Russia?
Desire for freedom.
Tom?
Oh, thank you, Bud. Number two, do you happen to know what Mr. Six's hobby is?
No, I don't know him so close.
Number two, maybe you could tell me, what is empennage? What does empennage mean? Do you happen to know?
Empennage, it's the rear section of airplane.
Thank you. Number three, how do you perform an outside loop?
An outside loop, you come up, turn, and go down.
Thank you. Number one, which side of the Potomac River is the airport on in Washington, please?
On the right side.
And what airfield is on the other side of the Potomac?
Well, I don't know the name.
Kitty.
Number one, where were you when you decided to make your try for freedom?
In Prague.
You decided to do this before you left the airport?
Oh, yes, 2 years before.
You had planned it? Number three, how many passengers did you have aboard?
There were 27 passengers aboard.
And number two, where did it say you landed? Where did you land? It says a base in Germany, but where?
Frankfurt.
You landed in Frankfurt. How many miles was that from your first start?
250 miles.
From where? From Prague?
Yes.
When you do this Gold Cup race, how long does it take you, number two?
All race?
Yes.
1 hour.
And where do you race from?
Don Amici.
Number one, what does coming over the barrier mean?
Barrier of speed.
Number two, would you agree with that?
Speed barrier?
Coming over the barrier. Does that mean anything to you?
No.
Mean anything to you, number three?
Well, it does. It means breaking the speed of sound.
Number two, what is the name of the two ways of landing in inclement weather? Do you know?
Three-point landing and two-point landing, you mean?
Number one, would you know the two ways of people bringing you in inclement weather?
The blind.
Do you know the names of the two ways?
I'm afraid that's all we have time for, panel. I'm sorry, sir. It's time now to vote, so if you will do so, and of course, without consultation, as usual, mark your ballots for number one, number two, or number three. Of course, as is customary, the team of challengers will receive $250 for every incorrect vote. Has everyone voted? All right, Tom, for whom did you vote this time?
This time, but I voted for number two. I forgot what I was going to say.
Kitty, for whom did you cast your ballot?
I voted for number three. He was very loquacious to be the real one, but he said about breaking the sound barrier, and I thought he was the one. I think number two looks more like it. Probably number one. I'm sorry to hear.
Don, what is your vote?
I voted for number two, Bud, and it's a pure out-and-out guess because I don't have the vaguest idea.
Polly, which one do you think is the real one in this first
round? I voted for number three. They were all... I have very little knowledge about boats or airlines. He knew who owned the boat that won the Gold Cup the year before last, but number one answered, I have no idea who it is.
All right. Having run down our own bit of voting, without those votes cast and in and recognized and our minds made up, let's see whether you made up your minds well at home, and we trust you're playing right along with us there, as we find out which of these three gentlemen is the one who flew the passenger plane to freedom. So Will Ariel, Miro Slovak, please stand up. We are proud to meet you, sir, believe me, to have you on the show. Number one, would you tell us your real name and what you really do, please?
My name is Jan Olvesia, and I'm a television actor in New York.
Television actor in New York. And number three, your real name and what you do.
My name is Milo Scupai, and I'm associated with the California Texas Oil Company.
Thank you, sir. Well, I hope you enjoyed it. And checking up on the score, we find there were two incorrect votes at $250 each for a total of $500 from Helene Curtis. And, of course, a gift package of all the fine beauty products made by Helene Curtis for your ladies. Congratulations to you, and good night and good luck. Now, panel, let's meet our next huge team of challengers.
What is your name, please?
My name is Lenore Jensen, and this is my younger sister, Mary Ann.
My name is Mary Ann Jensen, and this is my older sister, Lenore.
My name is Lenore Jensen.
My name is Mary Ann Jensen.
All right, panel, once again, will you please follow along with this affidavit? I, Lenore Jensen, a college junior, appeared on To Tell the Truth in November of last year and was questioned by these same four panelists. I had just won the 1959 United States Women's Small Bore Rifle Championship. This year, my younger sister, Mary Ann, a high school student, came to the national championships and with a borrowed rifle won the junior small bore championship and came within 2 points of beating me for the 1960 national women's title. Signed, Lenore Jensen. Panel, here is your problem. One of the three seated young ladies is the real Lenore Jensen, as you heard, rifle champion who has faced you before on this show. This time, she's brought with her her younger sister, Mary Ann, also a rifle champion. Now, you may question all six of the girls to find out which pair is actually the Jensen sisters. You may call the seated ones, as you usually do, number one, number two, number three, and the others referred to as younger sister, number one, number two, number three, etc. And we'll start this round with Tom Poston, Tom?
But how could you be so confident that we wouldn't all automatically recognize, Mr.
Well, we're sneaky, and we sort of feel that we fooled you before, we'll try to fool you again.
Well, you certainly did. I know I'd recognize Kitty and Polly. Maybe. Miss Jensen, number three, can you tell me the three sizes of 22 rifle shells?
Shorts, longs, and long rifles.
Thank you. Little Miss Mary Ann, is that right, number two? Can you tell me what makes a powder smokeless?
A powder smokeless?
Yes, the kind in the gun, I mean, of course, not a...
Well, the powder in the bullets in the gun is always, it always smokes when the bullet is out.
Oh, thank you. Miss Jensen, number one, how
did... Kitty, girl out.
Miss Jensen, number one, did we get you when you were on our program originally? Huh? We did?
Yeah.
Did we get you, number two?
I got two votes.
You got two votes. And number three, did we get you?
Mm-hmm.
All of us?
No, two.
Two votes. Did I get you?
No.
No! Remember the first time, I'll never remember it now. Number two, do you mind winning a small bore championship? Does that bring up terrible puns and so forth?
No, not at all.
Nobody bothers you on that. Little sister, number one. When you, I'm sorry. When you handle this rifle, does it have a kickback?
No, it doesn't.
None at all?
No.
Does a 22 have a kickback?
No.
Number two, what is recoil?
Oh, it's the bounce against your shoulder.
Number three, the little number three. What, what was the make of the rifle you used?
A Winchester.
Number one, little, what was the name of the shells that you used?
Winchester.
Number two, little number two, can you name me some other kinds of shells besides Winchester?
Well, I know there's a Remington rifle. That's the other rifle that, I've never used it. I've only used a Winchester rifle.
Number three, would you name me some other rifles? Could you name me some other? Number three?
Winchester and Remington.
The only two you know. Number one, what distance is a small bore rifle effective? At what distance?
About a mile.
Number two, would you agree with that?
Well, it's effective about up to a mile.
Polly.
Number two, you said you only use a Winchester, and it says here that you borrowed a rifle. Isn't it difficult when you have to be picky when you're borrowing?
You mean me, little sister?
Yes, little sister, I'm sorry, number two.
Well, my sister had the heavy rifle, and the kind of rifle that I had was a little lighter. And we knew this person that I borrowed the rifle from, and it was a heavy rifle just as my sister had.
She talks almost as much as I do.
Get to the point a little quicker, I think. And the time is up, Battle. You have to mark your ballots right now.
You will be a small boy. Without...
I vote for 5 and 6.
5 and 6. All righty. Mark your ballots, please. And as you do so, without consultation, vote for number one, couple number two, or pair of sisters number three. Oh, Mark, everybody voted?
Oh, why not?
Tom, for whom did you vote?
Well, I voted for number one. I tell you, I was a little hesitant about it, really, because I can't believe that a 22, even a long rifle, is effective up to a mile. I'll have to find out about that afterwards, right?
Kitty.
I voted for number one, not on the basis of her answers, but something, a kind of aura came to me that I'd seen her before.
Don, which is your choice?
I voted for number three, Bud. I think that the probably... I've never attended one of these tournaments, but I imagine that that garb that little number three is wearing is probably what they use to shoot in tournaments.
Okay, Polly? Which one do you think is the real one?
Well, with my glasses off, I don't recognize them now, and I'm sure I didn't recognize them before.
But don't bring them back again, Bud.
What is that?
I voted for number two, and number one looked very familiar. But because at this distance, almost everybody looks familiar to me. I voted for number two also because the little girl is sort of after my own heart. She's talkative.
All right, there we have it. Our rhymes and reasons that we discover now. In our own particular moment of truth, just how right or wrong we have become with our voting. So let's discover now which of these three pairs of sisters are the real rifle champions. Will the real Lenore Jensen please stand up?
ladies, I'm sorry I didn't have your glasses, because to look at the three pairs, you couldn't miss the resemblance between the two of them. They look so much alike. Let's find out.
I'm very sorry.
All right, we have some surprises for you, so hold on. Well, now, wait just a second. See what we have here for you. In case the other two Lenore Jensens look familiar to you, as you said, we want to tell you that they were also on that November show.
I know.
They were the two imposters. Of course, that's right.
And I bet we voted for the same wrong one.
I'd like you to meet them again. The law number one, tell us your real name, what you do.
My name is Diana Hoxie, and I work at Salter's Bookstore.
That's what she did before. And Lenore number two.
My name is Patricia Webster, and I'm a ticket agent for Brana Fairway.
Now, let's meet the...
For before.
I don't. They might, but I haven't got time
to
check now.
Do you remember two men voted for me and the two women voted for Diana?
Yes, they voted for her again. Well, I didn't want to hurt your feelings,
Emma. Let's find about the Marianne's now. Marianne, number one, your real name, what you do?
My name is Janet Burns, and I'm a drama student at the American Shakespeare Academy here in New York.
Bless you. And Marianne, little sister, number two.
My name is Jerry Gassick, and I'm an eighth grade student at Benjamin Franklin Junior High School in West Englewood, New Jersey.
Well, bless you all. We've had a lot of fun, and I sure hope you did.
Sure you aren't related to me?
You're fascinated with the same needle, I think. In any event, checking the score, we find there were 1, 2, 3 incorrect votes. Not bad, since it's a big mob here to satisfy. Total of $750 from Helene Curtis, and of course, a gift package of all those fine Helene Curtis beauty products. Thank you so much for playing our little trick on the panel. Good night and good luck. Let's meet our third team of challengers.
What is your name, please?
My name is Robert Gray.
My name is Robert Gray.
My name is Robert Gray.
Again, panel, read your copies of the affidavit with me. I, Robert Gray, am a member of President Eisenhower's White House staff. I was formerly acting appointments secretary to the president until I took over my present position. I now sit in on every meeting of the president's cabinet. It is my duty to prepare the agenda for the cabinet meetings and to make sure that decisions made by the president at these meetings are implemented. My position entitles me to a seat at the cabinet table, just 3 chairs from the president. My official title is Secretary of the Cabinet. Signed, Robert Gray. Back to the number 3 this time, panel. 3 gentlemen all claiming to be the Secretary of the Cabinet, Robert Gray. And we start with Kitty Carlisle. Kitty?
Thank you, Bud. I don't want to be impertinent, but for a gentleman who has to implement all that's decided at these meetings, you all look terribly healthy. Number one, you sit quite close to all the people who appear at the meetings, I'm sure. What is the color of Cabot Lodge's eyes?
His eyes? I have never noticed.
Number two, you know?
They're blue, I believe.
Number 3, can you tell me where the fireplace is situated to the desk in the president's study?
To the left.
To the left of the desk. Would you say that, number 1?
I agree with that, yes.
It is to the left of the desk. Number 2, what is the name of the president's airplane?
Well, there's no name given to the one now. It used to be the Columbine, but he just flies jets now that have no name.
Uh-huh. Number 3, were you appointment secretary before Eisenhower?
Don Amici, no. Please.
Number 3, what is the president's birthday?
Don't remember.
Number 2? October 14th.
Number 1, what day was it on, do you recall?
A Tuesday.
Number 2, what concern is Haggerty supposed to go with, is rumored to be going with when his term is up?
Well, rumor only is ABC, I believe.
Number 3, would you agree with that?
Yes.
Number 1, how many are in the cabinet?
18, including the president.
Number 2, who sits in the 2 closest chairs to the president, the ones inside of you?
Well, the Secretary of State sits to his right and the Secretary of Defense to his left.
Well, and you are where? You were 3 chairs away, you said?
Yes, to the left.
To the left? Well, who's in the other chair closest to you?
Secretary Benson is in the chair next to me.
Polly?
Number 1, who was the pilot of the Columbine?
Colonel Draper.
Number 3, there is a new carpet in the reception hall at the White House. Could you describe it?
Oh, I cannot. I've never been there yet. Too new.
Number 2, can you describe it?
In the reception hall.
In the big room where all the important people go.
Like Polly.
Like Polly.
I never done that. I've never even been in the White House.
How would you know about all?
I happen to know about this rug. I do. My brother-in-law made it.
Whether it's in the diplomatic reception room.
It's a new rug that was
it's oval and has some figures or something in it.
Number one, can you describe it?
No, I cannot.
Number three, quite recently, there was a collection of people who got together and donated things for the interior design of the White House. Could you name that group?
No, I cannot.
Number two, could you name the group?
No, I can't.
Number one?
No, I cannot.
I pass.
Tom Boston?
Thank you. Number three, can you tell me Jim Haggerty's former job?
No, I can't.
Number two, do you happen to know President Eisenhower's golf score at White Silver Springs in this recent tour?
No, I don't.
You don't, you devil. You'll be fired when you get back. Number one, can you tell me what kind of notepaper do you use to make your doodles on when you're working there with Captain?
I make no notes.
What was that again?
Will you kindly mark your ballot, panel, and vote as before without consultation for number one, number two, or number three. Okay, has everybody marked their ballot? Everybody, Tom, for whom did you cast your vote this time?
Couldn't possibly vote for number one after that admission. I vote for number two.
I voted for number two because I know that the 14th of October was not a Tuesday, it was a Friday. And I'm full of information like that. And number two knew about the color of Cabot Lodge's eyes, which are blue. And number three was not asked all these questions, so it might well be he.
Don, what about your choice?
I voted for number two also, partially for some of Kitty's reasons. And number one didn't know the president's birthday. As Kitty said, 14th was not a Tuesday.
Hurry, Polly? Don, I've been told to hurry.
Go ahead, Polly, the right maker.
I think it's number three because we didn't ask him any questions, but I voted for number two.
All right, it makes it unanimous for number two, apparently, so let's find out now whether we're right or wrong. When we're unanimous like that, it's sometimes fun to see as quickly as possible. So let's discover who of these three gentlemen is the real Secretary of the President's Cabinet. Will the real Robert Gray please stand up? You did mighty well. Number one, would you tell us your real name and what you really do, please?
My name is Joseph Knight, and I'm a district manager of the Equitable Life Assurance Society.
Thank you, sir. And a job well done. Number three, your real name and what you do.
My name is Harry Rounds. I'm a county executive and vice president of Davis Dorland Insurance Brokers, New York City.
Thank you, sir. And on the voting side, unanimous by the panel, which means no incorrect votes. Therefore, $150 from Helene Curtis as a gift, as well as another gift, a gift package of all of the fine beauty products made by Helene Curtis for your ladies. Gentlemen, thank you so much for being with us. Hope you had a few chuckles. Good night and good luck. That's all the time we have for tonight, panel, except I commend to you a wonderful article in November Cosmopolitan about our own lovely Kitty. Read it. You'll love it. Lovely picture of her, too. I guess that's it on the Vital Statistics Department. Good night, panel.
Good night, Bud.
God bless. Bud Collier saying good night from Helene Curtis and reminding all of you to tell the truth. Good night, everybody.
Tell the Truth is a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production in association with the CBS Television Network. Has been brought to you by Helene Curtis, makers of fine beauty products, creators of Enden Dandruff Treatment Shampoo and new Tender Touch Dry Skin Bath Oil. Johnny Olson saying goodnight from To Tell the Truth. This program was pre-recorded.